Hi guys, it's me Anne from Geeks of Green, and today I will talk about how to grow plants and propagate plants in semi-hydroponics. Before we get into this video, I'd like to quickly remind you to participate in the monthly giveaways that we do. And this is the last giveaway for 2021, which is sponsored by the Geeks of Green store. Do check out our store as well. We have a lot of planty merchandise that will help you flaunt your hobby by wearing totes and using coffee mugs that have plants that we love on them. Today, we will only cover the basics of semi-hydroponics, how to go about and how to start growing your plants in semi-hydro. We won't go into too much detail and we won't talk about advanced topics today. So I hope you really learn something and you enjoy this video as well. There are many home gardeners that prefer growing plants in soilless mediums and also in hydroponics, that is completely in water, and in semi-hydro as well. So if you had to ask me which is my preferred method, I would say you go with semi-hydroponics because it is a very safe method to use to propagate your plants and also grow them happy and thriving as well. There are many gardeners I know who grow many plants in semi-hydro completely. I recently, maybe some time back, started this method, started experimenting with this, and I found that the results are quite good. And especially if you want to propagate your plants, then this is a go-to method. You can also use semi-hydroponics for saving plants that are dying. Sometimes some plants are expensive and they are very fussy and they take time to adjust, especially after transit. After you've bought them from another city, another state, they've traveled for a bit, they are very stressed. You can always keep them in semi-hydro and help those plants to adjust to your environment. So I have used semi-hydro for all these purposes, and I don't mind growing a lot of plants in semi-hydro because the benefits are that you don't overwater your plants with semi-hydro. There's no chance of overwatering and there's no chance of underwatering as well if you keep the reservoir full, that is. If you forget the plant on a shelf and forget to refill the water, then probably your plant will die of underwatering. But it is much better than a plant growing in soil or in some substrate where the substrate tends to dry up more easily and more quickly compared to semi-hydro. So semi-hydro has all its ups. You just need to keep a few things in mind how to implement it in your home garden. So I will be covering all the bases today. So first, let's quickly talk about the mediums that you will use for hydroponics. There are many mediums that are there in the market that you can use and that people use. But the most common and the most popular one and the most used one, I would say, is the LECA balls that we have. I'm sure you've come across these LECA balls. They look something like this. There are sizes. As you can see, some you get that are bigger. And there are smaller sizes. There are different types as well. But we won't get into the details of LECA. The full form of LECA is lightweight expanded clay aggregate. So it's clay balls that are heated and they expand. They become very lightweight and they are very porous as well. So the mediums that we use for semi-hydroponics have to be porous and have to be able to absorb water very well and provide water to the roots of the cutting or the plant as well. This medium is easy to get your hands on. It's now available in many local nurseries, at least in our area. I find it in many local nurseries. So you just have to look for it. And if you're living somewhere where you're not finding it in your local nurseries, it's definitely there on Amazon. So you can check that out as well. The cost of this medium is lower compared to the other mediums that I will speak about. So I would say this is a good medium to go with. If you're starting with hydroponics, this is really good to go with. I love gardening, but there's another hobby that I really enjoy, which is baking. Since the Christmas season is here, just like every year, we will be baking a lot of goodies as a family this year too. Everyone, including the kids, wait for this time to bake together, and we love making cakes, cookies, marzipan, chocolates, and many other sweets. One of our favorite activities is making sugar cookies and decorating them. While browsing through Skillshare, I came across a class, Cookie Decorating for Beginners, Create Incredible Edible Art by Laurie Shannon. She's an icing artist and is very good at her work. Decorating sugar cookies brings together two things I love to do, baking and creating art. The class gave me tips and tricks to make clean sugar art and also inspired me to make designs that my kids enjoy. And they really do look very cute and pretty, don't they? There are many other baking classes for beginners, especially if you are new to baking and want to get your basics right. I would really recommend you try out these classes. Skillshare is an online learning community, and at Skillshare you will find classes for almost any topics you may be interested in. They are curated by industry leaders. Also, because they place a high emphasis on learning, you will never find any distracting ads here as well. They also have some wonderful classes on gardening that you should certainly check out. So how this works is you buy an annual subscription for less than Rs 2000, which comes to less than Rs 166 per month. For that amount, you get access to each and every class available on Skillshare. That is less than what you would pay to buy a money plant at the nursery. To me, that is a whole lot of learning for a little amount. So if this has inspired you and you need a push to explore something new, I have good news for you. The first 1,000 people to use the link given in the description below get a 1 month free trial access to Skillshare to explore the platform. The other medium that I've been using and I've found great success with are these granulates. This one I got from an online store called Green Carpet. I will put the link in the description. And it's an excellent medium to grow your propagations in. Many plants do well in this medium. I will talk about that in a little bit more detail as the video proceeds. Then there is this other granulates that I got from Nicole Castellino, Plant Princess, on Instagram. I will put her handle in the description also, so you can check her out. She makes this granulate and she sells it. So she sent me this box and I will be trying it out. I have some cuttings that I will be putting in this and I will be testing it out. So this is another mix that that you can use for semi-hydroponics as well. If you want to make your own granulate mix, I will probably in the future do a video for you on that as well. Now, these granulates that I've got here resemble the lechuza pon, which is very popular these days in the West. And many home gardeners use that for hydroponics to propagate plants and to save dying plants. So these granulates are very similar to lechuza pon because you don't get lechuza pon in India. And it's also very expensive if you want to get it from the US or something like that. So I'm quite happy with these granulates. You can also make them yourself. So if you are looking for a video how to make your own granulates, probably I will do something for you in the future after I experiment a bit. These are the mediums that I have used for semi-hydroponics. There are also other mediums that people use. If you Google, you will find a number of such mediums. Like people use perlite. I've heard people use vermiculite. Some use gravel, sand, and pumice. So there are many things that you can use as semi-hydro. I also use grow my pingicula on pumice rocks. So if you have smaller pumice bits, you can also use it for other plants. That's also another very good medium for semi-hydro. Now let's move on to the next part and let's talk about what we need to set up our first semi-hydroponic setup. Okay, so the container is extremely important. What you're going to use as the container, there will be an inner pot that you will need to use in which all your aggregate fits in. And it needs to have a lot of drainage holes at the bottom. Now, this is an orchid pot that I got from Amazon. They are a little bit on the expensive side. So if you're very serious about semi-hydroponics and you want to grow your plants in this manner, then you can probably invest in these pots, but they're a little costly. If not, if you're just starting up, I would say you can also use these small plastic pots that have a lot of drainage holes at the bottom. If your plastic pots don't have drainage holes at the bottom, just poke a few more holes. You can also use the bottom of a Coke bottle and poke a lot of holes in the bottom and put your aggregate in it. even this plant is sitting in a normal plastic pot that has a lot of drainage holes in the bottom. And you can see this plant is established. It's a Sindhbath cutting, a Begonia Sindhbath. And it's doing so well in this setup. It's not shown any signs of stress. It's taken root and it is growing happily. So I'm going to keep it like this for a very long time. The next thing that you will need is an outer pot that acts as a reservoir to hold the water in. It should not have any drainage hole at the bottom, of course. And this will sit, this inner pot with the holes will sit inside this reservoir and it will soak the water up from the reservoir. So you can use anything as the outer pot. For this decursiva, Raphidophora decursiva, I'm using a bowl that sits as a reservoir. I've removed the water right now because I will be showing you how much water and what goes in. This is another pot, a fiber pot that I have, and another plastic pot sitting inside. This is another way to keep your hydroponic system. Now, I also have some glass jars filled with leca and they don't have any drainage hole. This doesn't have a reservoir, so I have to be very careful as to how much water is there in this pot. So because it's glass, you can see and you can judge as to how much water needs to be there. You have to pour very little water and be very careful, and you have to keep an eye so that it doesn't dry out completely as well. So if you have a reservoir that is an outer pot, that is the best way to grow your plants hydroponically. But if you want, you can also keep it in these glass containers. I have quite a few cuttings growing in these glass containers, which are doing quite okay. So it's up to you to grow it the way you want. Just a thing to remember is when you are planting your cutting in leca, it's extremely difficult to get it out of a narrow mouth. So the root system, and if everything grows within that glass jar, it'll be very difficult for you to get it out because the roots will completely hold the leca balls and it'll fuse it in the bottle. So once you've put it in, it will be probably impossible for you to get it out of that narrow mouth bottle. So remember that when you are putting your plants in such settings. The best thing that I would recommend is go with wide mouth plastic containers which sit in an outer pot. That's the best way to do your semi-hydroponics. This is another setup that I made where I had put my Begonia Louisbourg in this plastic pot. I did not give it an outer pot, but I gave it a deep dish which holds water and which provides water from the bottom. So whenever I water, I pour water from the top and it fills the bottom. And the little water that sits in the dish is enough to provide water for this plant, and this plant has been growing well. So you can work around and you can try your own setups and do your own thing, but it's an exciting way to grow your plants. So now what we will do is quickly I'll show you how to put a cutting and make your first hydroponic setup if you have not done it till now. I will be using this orchid pot. You can use any of the containers that I mentioned. It's up to you. Now, you got to fill this up with whatever aggregate you're using. If it's granulates or if it's leca, fill it up at least halfway. And I've got these cuttings that I wanted to propagate for some time. It's been sitting in water for a couple of days. So I'm just going to take the pedatum. It's the sturdiest cutting, I would say. The philodendron pedatum. It's all tangled. So this is a philodendron pedatum cutting. I will be putting it into this pot here. It's got a sturdy branch, so it will stay and it will stand firm. And then I will fill it up with leca balls so that it can support itself and stand independently. Now, there are some plants in my experience that have not done well in leca or in these granulates, like the string of hearts. I have it in sphagnum. It almost died and my string of hearts is coming back now. It's just sitting in plain sphagnum moss and it's growing back. So some plants with finer roots, tinier roots, might not be able to stand happy in these leca setups or in the granulate setups. Hoyas do very well. Nicole Castellino swears by the granulates for her Hoya collection. If there is an issue, she just pops it in granulate. So Hoyas do really well. Then even philodendrons, monsteras, they do really well. Mostly any plant will do well in semi-hydroponics. So what I've done is I've filled it up to the brim and the plant is standing steady, which is good. Now I will pop this inner pot into the outer pot, which is the reservoir. I will not put plain water in it. I will be putting nutrient water. And the reason that I will put nutrient water in it is that these plants require macro and micronutrients, just like all our plants that are growing in soil do. They do not get it from these substrates. Okay, these substrates are inert and they do not provide any nutrients to the plant. If the plant has to grow and if the plant has to thrive, you need to add a little bit of nutrient water to make your plant thrive. In a bit, I will show you the nutrient water that I use and I will put the link of that in the description as well. Now, remember that these are not sponsored brands. They are just things that I'm using and I'm mentioning them to you. Also, one more thing is that certain granulates come with a little bit of nutrient bits in it. So always try and ask the seller if they have put any fertilizer in it, or you might end up over-fertilizing. Or what you can do to be safe is put half strength of the nutrient water, dilute it double, and then put it into your hydroponic solution. Or first, when you just start using that medium, wait for a month before you use nutrient water. Use plain water first. So you have to be a judge of that and you have to find your own way. Now we just pop it in and our hydroponic setup is ready, just that it doesn't have any nutrient water. Now the fertilizer that I use is this Green Loop fertilizer, which you will find on Amazon. And they come in two bottles, bottle A and bottle B, which you have to dilute each bottle in 1 liter of water. So bottle A is diluted in 1 liter of water here and bottle B is diluted in 1 liter of water here. Then what you have to do is take 10 ml of this, 10 ml of this and put it in a liter of water and then use it for your hydroponics, semi-hydroponics, hydroponics or semi-hydroponics. This is a hydroponic solution, which we will be using for our semi-hydroponics as well. There you go, my nutrient water is ready. Now I just have to fill the reservoir to a particular level, maybe to this level. Never fill it all the way up, maybe half. That is, you have to be a judge of that to see how much your plant requires. Okay, so since this is a sturdy plant, it's a peritum, it's a very healthy cutting of a peritum, I am going to put a full strength nutrient water. You can use half strength as well for more delicate plants. I'm just watering from the top and of course I have to keep checking as to how much water is getting into my reservoir. That's it. Okay, so I will keep an eye on this plant and see how it is drying up and based on where I place it. So let's see how it works. Sometime back, I did a tour of Plantastic Sunny's home. And if you remember, if you've watched that video, you will remember that he had so many plants growing in semi-hydroponics and he swore by it. So even I would definitely recommend this method if you don't want to get into the hassle of overwatering, and if you don't want, if you want a soilless medium and a hassle-free medium, this is a good way to go. Now, when do you water your semi-hydroponic setup? Whenever the water in the reservoir dries up or the level goes down, you can replenish it with the nutrient water that you have made. So here I have my decursiva and this is completely dry. So I will be just putting from the top a little bit of nutrient water and I see the level rising up. That's it. I bent a little too much, but it's okay. So this is sitting in a bowl of water and the plant is going to grow happy. And this is nutrient water. So the plant gets everything that it wants. Every time this dries up, I just add a little bit of nutrient water. If you're a little scared to use full strength, you can always use half strength. And especially for the more delicate plants. one main reason that I got bought in by this method is because I saw this particular plant, this Raphidophora decursiva, come back to life from just a small rotting piece of stem. I put it in these granulates and I kept it in water under a LED tube light, and the plant simply came back to life. It grew leaves, now it's on 3 leaves. And from a small, tiny, rotting cutting, it didn't have any leaf on it. It's just come to this, which makes me so happy that I could save a plant. There are many gardeners that I've seen on Instagram who have always shared stories about how they have saved their plants, how they've grown plants in semi-hydroponics and how it's worked so well for them. So this is a very good method. I also believe that because of the moisture that is around the plant, it also increases, bumps the humidity around the plant and keeps the plant a little bit happier. So the plant is never wanting for water, and also it is never overwatered at the same time. So this is a hassle-free method, and I would definitely encourage you guys to try it out as well. If you've already tried it out, if you have some tips to share with all of us, do put it in the comments down below. It really helps the community. Another tip that I would like to tell you that I heard about, which I have not done so far, is if there is a salt buildup in your aggregate, in between changing the water, you can just hold it under good, clean, soft water and wash the substrate of extra salts. If it's held under running water, all the extra salts that have accumulated, the minerals that have accumulated, will get washed off. So you can probably try that out as well. I have never done that, so I wouldn't vouch for this technique, but it's just something that I've heard. I really hope that this video helped you in some way. And if you want to know more about hydroponics, semi-hydroponics, if you want me to experiment more, do let me know in the comments down below. I will definitely try to make more videos for you. And I hope to see you soon in the coming video. Till then, stay green.